Hi, it's Vicky here with a fun event this week. Join me every day for a new video where I will be featuring penny black stamps, creating each day a Valentine's Day card. For my first card today, I will be using this beautiful stamp. This comes from a stamp set that's called Love and Hugs. And first of all, I will be creating some ombre look on my background. I am using some Nina White cardstock as my background. And this is the 80 pounds. And I am going to apply three different colors of distress ink. I am going for an ombre look, so I am starting from my lighter color and moving on to the middle color and then to the darker one. You can see the colors that I've used on screen right now. Now, although it looks a little bit splotchy, I am going again and again all over it, making sure that it's nicely saturated with ink, and you will see that at the end it's going to be blended beautifully. Another thing that you need to keep in mind when you are blending and distressing is that when it dries, it becomes lighter, so it's not going to be as vibrant as it looks at the moment. Once I'm finished with all the three colors, I will go ahead and use my lighter color and go all over the three colors just to make sure that they are nicely blended. And you can see in this video that I went a little bit old school, so instead of using my blending tools, the round mini blending tools by Tim Holtz, I have used the old square ones just because I needed to cover up a bigger area. I usually get a lot of questions about this technique, and all I do is going really soft with the blending tool and letting the blending tool do the whole work. Now, I'm not pressing at all, and I prefer to go ahead and load my blending tool many times instead of loading it too much and then not being able to blend the color that I have moved on my paper. And here is my final background. I am planning to do some white embossing, and that's why I need to make sure that the ink is totally dry. After using my heat gun to make sure that it was dry, I am applying some powder with my embossing body. This is going to make sure that there is no static electricity on my paper, and my embossing powder is going to stick only where the stamped image is. So while I am doing that, just to let you know that there is a giveaway. So if you want to win a $25 gift card for shopping on the online store by Penny Black, make sure to visit my blog and check out all the details. You actually need to go to the Penny Black Facebook page, like their page, and leave them a comment that Vicky sent you. So now I have stamped my image, and I am going to apply white embossing powder. This is Wow embossing powder, and it's bright white. And I am going to use my heat gun to heat set it. I am going to use my craft knife and cut out the inside of the card. Now this can become easily a shaker card, which is not what I will be doing today. So I am using my scissors, and I'm very carefully going along the lines to cut out the inside of the heart. And this is pretty easy because you have that raised embossed area that is a great guide for cutting out the image perfectly. As always, you can find the full list of all the supplies that I'm using today just below the video in the description area, as well as on my blog. Now I have a white scrap paper, which is big enough to cover up the back of that heart. So I am applying some spun sugar, which is the lighter of the three colors that I've used on my main panel. And now I'm going to apply this product, which is by Faber-Castell. It is called Glass Bead Glitter Gel, and it is just a beautiful medium. Although it looks white at the moment, it's going to dry transparent, and it's going to pick up the color that I have at the base. So this adds a nice texture just because it has a small little glass beads, which are going to be visible once this is dry. I am using my spatula to apply the medium, and I am making sure that it's nice and leveled. But of course you can use it to create more texture, and you can also use it with stencils. So I am going to leave this aside to dry for now. You can always use your heat gun to dry it. And I am going to go with my sentiment. In this stamp set there is a sentiment that says hugs, which I am going to white emboss again on top of my card. I have stamped it with Versamark ink, and again I am going to apply the same white embossing powder, the bright white by Wow. So this is going to be a fun week where I will be creating a new card every day from Monday to Friday, so make sure to join me. I had lots of fun making those cards and I hope you will have too watching me doing them. Now here are the glass beads, which is now dry, and you can see that it has picked up the spun sugar from the bottom. And I wish you could see the texture on it. I can only catch the sparkle on the camera, but it really is like a bunch of micro glass beads. So anyway, I have used some foam tape at the back along with some tape runner, and I'm going to stick it on top of a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5. And that was the card for today. Here are a couple of close-up photos. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. And if you need more inspiration, here are two more Valentine's Day cards that I did last year using again Penny Black products. Thank you all for watching.